Good morning everyone. Today we are starting chapter 2, types of hardware. Computer hardware. Computer hardware is collection of physical parts of a computer system. All the physical parts which are connected with the computer. Classification of the hardware, you can see all input devices, output devices, storage devices, and some devices are there inside the CPU. Computer memory. Computer memory is divided into two memory, main memory and auxiliary memory. Main memory is also known as primary memory, and secondary memory is also known as auxiliary memory. Here, primary memory is of two types, RAM and ROM. Secondary memory contains hard disk, CD, DVD, etc., which stores the data permanently. Main memory holds instructions and data when a program is executing, while auxiliary memory holds data and programs not currently in use and provides long-term storage. Memory units. Memory units are used to measure and represent the data. So most commonly used are bit. Bit you all are familiar. It's 0 and 1. It is actually the smallest unit of computer memory. Now byte. Byte is the fundamental unit to measure data, and it is equal to 8 bits. Now kilobytes. A kilobyte contains 1024 bytes. Megabyte contains 1024 kilobytes. Gigabyte contains 1024 megabytes, and terabyte contains 1024 gigabytes. There are two standards, ASCII and Unicode. ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Unicode stands for Universal Character Set. ASCII contains representation for digits, English letters, and other symbols. It supports at least 128 characters. Unicode supports wide range of characters. This is the main difference between ASCII and Unicode. Bits per character. ASCII uses 7 bit to represent a character, while Unicode uses 8 bit, 16 bit or 32 bit depending on the encoding type. The Unicode requires more space than ASCII, and the conclusion is that Unicode represents most written languages in the world. ASCII represents small letters, capital letters, digits and symbols such as punctuation marks, etc. While Unicode represents letters of English, Arabic, Greek, Hindi, many of the languages, mathematical symbols, historical scripts, emoji, covering a wide range of characters than ASCII. Main memory or primary memory is of two types, RAM and ROM. Main memory is actually a physical memory that is internal. These two memories, RAM and ROM, these we have to connect with motherboard. So they are internal to computer. The word main is used to distinguish it from the external mass storage devices like disk drive. Got it? Memory include RAM and primary storage. The computer can manipulate only data that is in main memory. So difference between RAM and ROM. RAM is random access memory. ROM is read-only memory. RAM is volatile in nature. ROM is non-volatile. RAM is temporary memory, ROM is permanent memory. The data in the memory, RAM, data in the RAM is lost when the computer is turned off. And in ROM, the data, the memory keep its content even if the power is lost. The more RAM system has, the faster it will learn, it will run. As you can see, your mobile phones also, we need to clear RAM if we want to work it fast. Usually used to store the essential program drivers to start the computer. Storage devices is any hardware capable of holding the bulk of data or small amount of data permanently. So first example is hard disk. Hard disk is also known as hard drive or HD or HDD. It is non-volatile in nature. That means the data will remain in hard disk permanently. It will not lost when the power is turned off. The data storage device. It is usually installed internally in a computer attached directly to the disk controller of the computer's motherboard. Okay, you can see this is internal hard disk and it is there inside the CPU and directly connected to the motherboard. It contains one or more platas. Okay, one or more disk is there and housed inside of an air sealed casing. Data is written to the platas using a magnetic head which moves rapidly over them as they spin. CD-ROM. Its full form is compact disc read-only memory. It is an optical disc. It can contain audio, software, data, whatever you want to copy in it, and it will be read-only. It cannot be modified. CD-ROM drive or optical drive is the device used to read them. These drives are capable of playing audio CDs and reading data CDs including CDR and CDR read-write disc. DVD, digital versatile disc. It is actually an alternative for video cassettes that were used earlier and the CD-ROM. It can acquire 7 times larger amount of data relative to the CD. It can render videos with excellent picture quality and random access. It is built from the same material as the CD is made of, but the process and the layers are different. It is used from both the sides, such as two CDs are sticking together. The reason why it provides greater size than a CD are dense packing of the bits, use of shorter wavelength laser, and generation of two-sided disc. Data can be read from right to both the sides. Okay, data can be read and write on both the sides of the disc. Blu-ray disc. It is also known as BD or BD-ROM. It is an optical disc. It can store up to 25 GB single layer disc and 50 GB on a dual layer disc and are the same size as a standard CD. So the blue laser drive is here. You can see it uses blue laser light to read or write the Blu-ray disc. Memory sticks are used as storage media for a portable device in a form that can easily be removed for access by a personal computer. They are very small in size, come in greater variety of shapes and formats that make them fit many mobile devices such as digital cameras, e-readers and cell phones. All flash drives are USB devices. They are called flash drive because they use flash memory to store files. Flash memory is a type of computer chip. Cloud storage. It is a service model in which data is transmitted and stored on remote storage systems where it is maintained, managed, backed up and made available to users over a network, typically internet. Users generally pay for their cloud storage on a per consumption monthly rate. Clients send files to a data server maintained by a cloud provider instead of or as well as storing it on their own hard drives. We can consider an example for cloud storage. It is Google Drive. It is actually free of cost. For that, if we have to use Google Drive, simply we have to connect with Google account. Okay, it will be Gmail username and password. With that, we can log in into Gmail Drive, and then after that, we can upload files on it, and it will be there on the Google Drive for a long time. So it is very simple example of cloud storage. Primary memory versus secondary memory. Primary memory is the main memory, such as RAM. Secondary memory is auxiliary memory or external memory, or it holds data or instructions that are currently in use. Secondary memory is used to store and retrieve the data or information on a long-term basis. Primary memory is volatile memory. Secondary memory is non-volatile. Data is directly accessed by the CPU, and secondary memory, the data is not directly accessed by the CPU. Primary memory, data is lost when the device loses power. But in secondary memory, data is intact even when the device loses power. Common examples of primary storage include RAM, ROM, and cache memory. Here, the example of secondary memory is hard disk, CD, DVD, floppy disk, flash drives, etc. Thank you. Have a nice day.